Hello friends, good morning. In this session, we will discuss how to code a class with a variable and functions. In one of the lectures, we have already seen what is a class is. Let us take a revision of that and then we will continue our discussion. So, basically, class is a collection of variable and functions or the methods. Here, we have a one diagram. The diagram shows that there's a one class. Here we have a variables and methods. Let us take a practical example of triangle class. The class triangle will have a height and base as the variable and get data, show data, calculate area, calculate perimeter. These are the same basically methods we have. Here in a Java, you should use the camel notation for the variables and methods. That's the first letter of the first word should be small. The first letter of the second word must be capital. So this is a camel notation. So this is a basically class triangle with a two variables and four methods. Now let us start coding for the triangle class. Now consider the three objects of the triangle. Here we have a three object. How they differ from their height and base? See the picture over here. The first object of triangle has a height equal to 1 and the base equal to 1. Similarly, the second object has assumed that is a height equal to 2, the base equal to 2 unit. Similarly, for the third object, height equal to 3. The base equal to 3. Now let us see how we can calculate the area of a triangle on the basis of base and height. So for calculating the area of the triangle, the equation is, or the formula is, 1/2 into base into height. If you will put 3 by 3, then you will get a 4.5 as the area. Now let us start the coding. Now let us go for coding the triangle class step by step. First of all, open the command prompt. Provided that you have done all the setting of path and class path variable over here. Again, make sure that suppose your command prompt is pointing to the what is the location. On the same location, basically your Java file should be there. Now open the notepad and write down the code like this. For saving the time, I have written this code and we are opening that saved code. This is the comment, we know that one. Here we have a class triangle. In a Java, whenever you are writing the name of the class, the first letter must be the capital. That's the coding standard we have to follow in a Java. Here we have an entry point of the program. That's the main. What we are doing is, we are writing the class triangle step by step. Now first, basically this program, we will write only the main, very simple main, and then gradually we will add some more code in this triangle class. Now here in a main, the signature is public static void main string argument. You have to follow this signature. What the changes you can do is, you can put any variable name over here, any valid variable name. Like you can say, instead of the R's, you can say suppose S, something somebody says O, or what is the same things we want to put it over here. And then we have put on system.out.println. In an inverted comma, again whatever we have put on, that the message will be printed. Let us compile it. For compilation, Java C, then triangle 1.java, and then the file will be compiled. We know that whenever we will compile the file, at that time this class file will be just generated. See, what is the name of the class? Class name is a triangle. So that's why the class file with a triangle will be generated. If you have given the name as a what is the supposed test, so test class file will be the generated. Now here what we require to do is we require to execute this file, that's class file, and that class file is basically bytecode file. Now let us check it. Is it a bytecode file or the class file we have opened? See, fine. Okay, now we want to execute that. So Java, for execution we have a Java, then space and the name of this file. What is the name of this file? That's a triangle. Triangle, you do not require to put a dot class. See, the program is executed. Fine. So this basically we have our program, and this is our execution. Program started from this point, and here we have written in main. So in main has been written. Suppose after this, if you have put on something else, so whatever you have put on over here, that will be printed over here in our this execution. Now let us go to the second program. In the second program, what we are doing is we are putting the variables and functions of class triangle. We have seen in our PPT the class triangle has a two variables. These are the base and height. And the class triangle has a four functions. These are the four functions of a class triangle. See, the very first function is a get data. For the simplicity, all the function does not have any coding. We have simply function started, that's a curly brace, and ending curly brace we have put on. Similarly for the show data and the other two functions we have coded. So as compared to the previous program, we have added the two variables and four methods or the functions. We have not done any change in a main function. So simply if we will execute the program, it will print in main and end of the main. Let us check it. Is a Java C. And then Java. In main and end of the main.